Welcome, welcome, welcome. What a joyous time that we have been so excited about for this night right now. This is a time of celebration. In fact, we're calling this time right now celebration number one. And next November, we'll have celebration number two, which at that time we will have everything finished. We'll have already have dedicated it, and we're going to have a big celebration and hopefully 10 or 15 Kenyans here with us to celebrate. The last couple of years have been a challenge, and now we're here, and I know what the scripture means. I would have fainted unless I had believed to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. And so we're here now to say we have seen the goodness of the Lord. We welcome all of you that are with us tonight. Hold on your seats. You're definitely going to be blessed. Those who are joining us online, thanks for watching, and you're going to be blessed as well. And we're going to kick this off. We need to have at least one song from the Kenyans. They flew a long way, and so we want to have them start us off with just praising the Lord. Let's welcome them.
Wow, hallelujah. Well, it's so exciting to be here again and to just celebrate what the Lord is doing. And we were gonna sing some Swahili songs, but we just thought for the sake of Debbie, we're just going to do one. No, we'll do that at the end. What we want to say tonight is that the Lord has been so good. Actually, it's so, we're just going to have to get it together up here, but it's been an amazing 5 years. I know the last time I came here, I was telling somebody I was lower than a snake's belly. I think I said that right. But the scripture says, weeping may endure for a night, but joy. I said joy comes in the morning. Amen. Amen. So we're going to stand up and just worship the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, we bless your name tonight. We give you glory because you have been so good to us, Lord. You have been so awesome, so wonderful, Lord. We lift up our hearts to you tonight. God, we thank you for this moment that we can sing about your goodness. We can sing about your love. We can sing about your kindness, Lord. You have been so good. And Father, we give you glory and praise in Jesus' name. You, Lord, for your mercy never fails me.
All my days I'll be held in your hands. From the moment that I wake up till I lay my head, I will sing of the goodness of God.
Let's sing it again.
I love you. Fails me all my days. I've been held in your hand from the moment that I wake up until I lay my head. I will sing of the goodness of God.
All my life you have been faithful.
All my life you have been faithful. Close like no other.
We've known you, Lord.
I've known you as a father. I've known you as a friend.
I have lived in the goodness of God. Oh, yes, God, all my life you've been faithful.
All my life you have been faithful.
Yes, Lord, you have been so good.
All my life you have been so good. goodness of God.
Yes, Lord, all my life you have been faithful, Lord.
All my life you have been faithful.
We love you, Jesus. You have been so good.
All my life you have been so, so good. Every breath that I am in,
oh God, I will sing.
I will sing of the goodness.
Running after me with my life
laid out,
I surrender now. I give you everything. Your goodness is running after. It's running after me.
Oh God, your goodness is running after. It's running after me with my life.
Your goodness is running after. It's running after me.
Life laid down, I surrender now. I give you everything.
Your goodness is running after.
It's running after me.
All my life.
All my life you have been faithful.
Yes, Lord.
All my life you have been so, so good. Every breath that I am able,
I will sing of the goodness of God. We love you, Jesus. You are so faithful, Lord. We lift up your name tonight, God. We declare your goodness, your greatness over Mission Barnabas and over CMM, Lord. Over the past 5 years, Lord, you have done so much for us, God. We give you glory and praise. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name, amen. Wow, hallelujah.
Come on. Woo. Thank you, guys. Hallelujah. Well, you may take your seats. We are so blessed today. I want to take a few moments. Okay, test. It's been an amazing 5 years, and Pastor Ronnie asked me to share just for a few minutes what the timeline looks like when we look back at what the Lord has done. And I started thinking about it, and I realized it's been 5 years. It's actually in March of 2017, that's 5 years ago, when we were informed that our property was probably sitting on the SGR track. 5 years. They told us there were 7 routes, and out of those 7, 4 of them were passing right through our property. And so we prayed that they'll choose the other 3. But how many of you know the probability was very high? And so the first year in 2017, we call it the year of being informed that we are about to be taken. Because the entire year, it took a whole year for them to tell us we are actually taking your property. They told us that in July. They told us probably again in September. But it was actually at the end of November when they finally confirmed, after 4 different visits, that our route was the choice route for the SGR. Then 2018 came along. And in 2018, we call that the year of evaluation. They evaluated us over 4 times. And every time they came up with the same figure that they were to pay us, which was $9 million. They told, it was in January they did the first evaluation. They did it again in February. We did another one in March. We did another one in April. And we did another one in November of the same year. But in between that year, we had a very dark time. We consider it the lowest time. We were lower than a snake's belly at that time. But we know that our Redeemer liveth. Then in 2019, we call it the year of disputes. That was the year we had court case upon court case. The first court case began in November of 2018. It spilled over into 2019, January, February 2019. In fact, in 2019, we received so many threats. I was told the only person I knew was Ronnie. I said, that's a good start. Praise the Lord. I was told, you don't know anybody. We're gonna smoke you. We're going to destroy you. They wanted $2 million bribe, and we wouldn't give it. And so they canceled our word, and they said, you have no idea what you're up against. We will destroy CMM. We'll close it down. We will change your title deed. I mean, every kind of threat. It was the first time I considered being a Texas gun holding. I had bodyguards for 24 hours for about 4 months in the middle of all this. But you know, the scripture says in 2 Kings chapter 6 that there are some, the ones that who are for us are actually more than those who are against us. And so in the middle of all this fight, what they had no idea is that something God was doing on the other side. That was, you know, the way you go into battle and you can't see what's happening on the other side of the hill. So on this side, it looked like we're being defeated. But on the other side, oh hallelujah, there was a bulldog that was coming up the hill. And we'll give you more information on that later. Just hold on to that thought. And so that year was a year of disputes. We went to one court case of another. And at the end of September of 2019, it was just before the banquet that we had here in 2019, the court finally gave a verdict that Clarence Matheny was to be paid $8.5 million for the rebuilding of our property. And I remember I was here that day and I had the court order. Even though there was a few people who didn't have faith that we could actually get that money, it actually happened. And so in 2020, we call that the year of payments. We were finally paid on February the 28th. The court actually gave an order that anybody who tries to stop the funds from getting to CMM will be in contempt of court and they will be jailed for 6 months, and that's when they released our money. Actually, we had a judge who was born again, and I just stood there, and as he was giving the orders, we were all weeping and crying and thanking the Lord. So we can give the Lord praise on that one. Hallelujah. Actually, that year, this is 2020, after we were paid, we felt like the Lord began to restore all the years that we had lost. So that year, after we were paid, we began to look for new land. And so COVID hit, I almost said at the perfect time. Because when COVID hit, it affected the real estate market in Kenya. And so the prices of land plummeted. And so it was the best time for us to get land. And so we found a property in Limuru that is actually worth $2 million, but we got it for $1.3 million. That's when we knew it's happening. Hallelujah. And so God put a smile on our faces. We paid for the land in September of 2020, and we began to apply for the building permits. And just the application of the building permits and all that is required took us a whole 9 months. During the entire time, the country was closed down. A lot of offices were closed down, so it took us longer than normal. But we finally got our permit, and now we are in 2021, the year of rebuilding. Hallelujah. So on June 3rd, 2021, we had our chairman and his wife, Debbie, come to our new property. We had all the permits. We had all the contracts signed. And we had our groundbreaking ceremony on the 3rd of June, 2021. And we began reconstructing our new facility that you're going to see in just a little while. Oh, my God. There was still an amount that we had dispute, that is still under dispute and is still in court. And so the case is still going on for one of the final cases, which we believe we will win. And then CMM will be awarded another $1.4 million. Praise the Lord. And on October 24th or 25th, 4 months after the reconstruction began, we are at almost 30% complete. This year, we're trusting that by December, the residential zone will be completed, and some of our staff, including our chairman, will be able to move in. The testimony that we have today is that if a thief is caught, he will pay back 7 times. And so those who try to rob us of our inheritance, they have failed miserably. Praise the Lord. And everything that we have now is bigger and better and more is to come. We are trusting the Lord that by July 31st, 2022, we're calling that the year of restarting, we will be at 100% completion, and our chairman, together with our board, will be handed over the keys for the new Clarence Matheny Leadership Training Institute in Limuru. We also believe that on September 6th, we'll have a dedication service, and we shall launch our Bible school. In fact, I thought about this week, that it's been exactly 5 years since we planned the launch of our Bible college. We had actually planned this for September 2017, and now it is happening in 2022. Glory be to God. Look what the Lord has done. It's been amazing. Actually, we have moved from 55,000 square feet to 136,000 square feet. That's how much the Lord has multiplied CMM in terms of square footage. Okay? The old CMM only had 5 offices and a very small underground library that was always permanently flooded with water. Now we're going to have 20 offices and a huge library that's going to be the biggest library in East and Central Africa, biggest theological library. We'll also have an e-library. We'll move from having 1 dining hall to 2 amazingly beautiful dining halls. Our sitting capacity in the auditorium has increased to 1,200 Americans. That's about 2,000, count me in, youth. The guest house that we call Jewel House will have a dining hall of its own, and it will have the capacity to house 44 guests. We're also going to be having, in total, the entire CMM facility will have 1,020 beds, up from 350. We used to have 350 beds, now we'll have 1,000. So that's why I'm trying to do the maths. We could host 5,000, Ronnie. Yeah. Praise the Lord. So, just so we can make this practical, I want you to take a look at this video for just a few minutes and see what kind of development had taken place on October 1st, 2021.
Hello everyone, this is October the 1st, and we're wanting to give you an update of all that's been happening and how fast it's going. And 30 days from now, Pastor Chola will be in this exact spot giving you another update to show you what's happened just in the last 30 days. I got here 2 weeks ago to Kenya. I had not been out here since we had groundbreaking. When I walked onto the property, it almost took my breath away. So overwhelmed and amazed at how much has been done already. In the process of getting ready to do this, we really know that God sent us someone to be our contractor. In fact, I want to introduce him and his assistant as well. This is Andrew Sikoi, and this is Justice Kioki. And between the two of them, this is the contractor. They have done and are doing an awesome job. We had so many delays before over the last few years. We feel like with the way these things are going now, we are redeeming the time. To give you a good perspective, we're standing on one corner of the 14.2 acres. We have 3/4 mile of wall. When it's finished, it'll cover 3/4 miles. We have a 1/3 mile of road frontage. And we have nothing but beauty everywhere. For me personally, I've divided this into like 5 zones. Zone 1 is here on the east, on the east side of the property, and this is where the staff and the residence houses. We'll also have a quadplex that will have some staff for interns and so forth. All of that is being done now, and we'll be able to be moved in by Christmas. And all of our houses will be finished then, so we're very excited. Debbie and I are thrilled that we can come straight to our own home, not have to go to Airbnb. Zone 2 is the guest house, jewel house, and also recreation that we'll have above it. And then that jewel house will have 24 rooms, which the view will be incredible. Next to that is Zone 3, which is our admin block and building, which will contain our library, offices, classrooms. Just above it will be our auditorium. Our auditorium, it will seat 1,000 Americans are 1,500 Africans. So it's going to be plenty for us to enjoy. Then in Zone 4 will be our hostels and our dormitory. And the dormitory will have 110 rooms in it. And then next to it, Zone 5, is our maintenance and repairs and facility upkeep and care to take care of all the property. So we've seen everything. Now where we're at on October the 1st, and we are, every day we come out here, we see something is different and much more than we expected, and we're thrilled, we're excited, and all of this will be done by the, or sometime in July, everything will be finished. In August, we'll do a dry run by having some people stay and check out things in groups. And then we'll officially go with our conference in September of 2022. And then have our dedication, one of the first 2 weeks of September. And then right after that, we start the Bible College. We're excited. Let's hear now from Pastor Chola.
Yeah. Wow. Now hold on to your seat. Because I went to the property just before I came for this meeting. Last week, I was there exactly 27 days after that video. And the video is going to play now of how it looks like after 28 days. And you just keep your eyes on the screen. I'm going to be talking over the video. But basically, after exactly 21 days, when you go on the property now, the residential houses, which constitutes 4 houses and a quadplex, are 70% complete. Actually, 3 of them are almost at 90%, and 2 are now, they're working on the beams, they're working on the doors, they're working on the fence, they're actually working on the electrical and plumbing. 2 houses are completely plastered, both on the inside and outside. They are now doing the final stages of piping and connecting the sewers, and so that is really how it looks like now. 2 houses already completed the roof. The other 3, actually they were done the day I left. By the time I left, one of the houses had a complete roof. I'm telling you, this guy who's been building is quite serious. And then after that, if you look at the second zone, you're going to see it in just a minute. This is the Jewel Guest House. The Jewel Guest House and the small dining hall that is attached to the guest house are actually 20% complete. Oh, okay. Oh, sorry, yeah. We're still in the residential. Yeah, sorry. Yeah, so this is still the residential area that is 70% complete. It's actually fenced all the way around. They are now paving the road. By next month, they'll have a paved road. And then after that, we go to the second zone that's coming up. Just there, you can see the Jewel Guest House right there. A few days, when Ronnie was there 20 days ago, it was just a foundation. But after 27 days, the walls are all up on the sides. They are now working on building the top floor, because this building actually has 2 floors. So they're going to be putting the beam at the top and then putting a slab, and then they'll put up the next floor. So this is the second zone. The administration block, which is nearby, You can't see it from here, but they've already dug up the space for it. They were actually excavating and getting ready to start building the foundation for the auditorium. And then next to that, that's coming up there, is actually the dining hall, the main dining hall, and the kitchen and stores. This is the main dining hall that's going to be built. They've already been working on the foundation. They've raised up the walls inside the foundation pit, and so they're already starting to work on the floor for the dining hall and the kitchen stores. And then after that, what you're seeing now, what you're about to see, will be the foundation for the administration block. We have an administration block right there that has got two floors. 20 days ago, there was nothing here. There was just pits. But now after those number of days, they've put up the walls and everything is done. And then finally, what you're seeing on your pictures now is the last part, which is the maintenance area. They've already fabricated an office that we are already using. These are actually five C containers that were covered to create a nice temporary work environment. In fact, a couple of weeks ago when the chairman was in Nairobi, we did a chairman's lunch in that place. And we gave out Bibles, we preached the word to the workers, and 35 of them gave their lives to Jesus. Actually, they were the first people on site to receive resources coming right from here. So it's amazing. God is good. Wow. I tell you, we are so excited. In fact, I was going to say that all of this has been waiting and being built so that we can be able to start our Bible college. We have some brochures that are on your table now that we've given you to have a look at what's coming in terms of our Bible college. We have actually come up with the most affordable Bible college for the people that God has called us to. You all know that the people that we are reaching out to are those who are out in the areas where they don't have resources, they don't have teaching. And so our Bible college is crafted in such a way that it will give them opportunity for only $350 a semester to take a certificate in Christian ministry for three semesters and to take a bachelor's or even a diploma in Bible and theology. Actually, this is so timely, so you know that God is totally in control, because there's several laws that are in the works in parts of East Africa. This has already happened in Rwanda. If you've been checking on the news, you'll see Rwanda actually closed down 6,000 churches. I said that right, 6,000 churches last year. And that's because a lot of the people who go into the rural areas, some of them will start churches and they've never gone to Bible seminary, they've never gone to college, but they just have the fire. You know what I'm saying? They can pray and they can cast out devils. Hallelujah. Let's just begin there. You know, and so when they're out there, you know, we come across them and we equip them. We've done conferences, we've done meetings, but systematically the Lord has been directing us to begin to give them something more tangible. And now there's a law that has already been drafted in Kenya and in Tanzania. It's not been effected yet, because for you to decide you're going to affect this, you have to know what it means in terms of elections. And so right now, it's going to be required that every individual who leads a ministry, whether it's a church somewhere in the bush, for you to do that, you have to at least have a certificate from an accredited institution. And so Clarence Matheny Leadership Training Institute, our Bible college, will be accredited by the Africa Accrediting Body for Theological Colleges. Praise the Lord. So that's a big plus. So we're expecting that a lot of them are going to jam our doors to try and get into class, because the moment you sign up, the moment you register for class, it means your church is protected from being closed down. I was in Tanzania last week, and they had the same story. They were telling us, when are you open the Bible college? We want to sign up so that we can stop this that is coming. So that's a big plus. The other thing that we have done, which is so good about our Bible college, is that it's been designed in such a way that it doesn't interfere with their program at church. They can actually continue pastoring their churches as they come and attend Bible school. How have we done this? They're actually going to be in class every semester for only one full month. And over the weekend, they can go back home if they're within Kenya and Tanzania. Now we have SGR. And so they can go back and preach in their churches on Sunday and come again. And then after that 1 month of tuition, they will go for practicals, and they will continue doing some online classes. And that enables them to continue doing what they don't have to resign, basically, to get their diploma or their certificate. And so that is a big plus. But the other thing that we have done, we have also kept the main thing, the main thing. Even in the midst of all the pandemic and all that was going on, we decided, you know what, the best thing we can do is to continue reaching out to pastors in different areas. And so I'm going to invite Evangelist John, who's our regional director, to just let us know how we have done this in this year of the pandemic. Welcome, John.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. I love the fact that we can be a team. Hallelujah. Glory to God. A team in the U.S., a team in Kenya, and I love what the team has been doing. You know, the structure, the mortar, the brick, and all that. But we are talking about the people now. Glory to God. Hallelujah. What we all do all this? We do all this to touch the people. And so this year, you know, of course, with the pandemic going on, we didn't have opportunity to really be as free as we all, you know, ordinarily are. But the good thing is, and the good news is that this year, with all the lockdown and everything, somehow God just kept us going. He just said, you know, we're going to dare, and go ahead and share the gospel, and touch some pastors, minister some pastors. And so we went to various places, we went into various towns. I think you could probably see over there, just, I don't know if the numbers are up there. But yeah, so we were able to go to several cities and touch some several pastors there. In fact, we just came back, like Pastor Chola mentioned, we just came back from Tanzania last week. And all together, this year, we have seen face-to-face and had opportunity to minister to over 1,600 pastors, which is actually the highest number of pastors we've ever done, really, you know, in a year. So this is fantastic. We are so grateful to God. But I also want to just share a very quick good report and testimony. I'm actually an ambassador of Thanksgiving today. Hallelujah. You know, we have about 80 what we call regional coordinators, you know, from the various parts of the country. They are people who have been at CMM forever, and they love CMM, and so they come and they organize, you know, from wherever they are coming from. They organize people on teams to come to the conferences in March and all that. So we have all these representatives, about 80 of them. And so, you know, this team of coordinators, they you know, they help to get our conferences filled up and all that. And they're very, very faithful. In fact, when we're going through this five-year ordeal, we had opportunity for them to just you know, take a chance to pray for CMM. And they loved the vision. They prayed for a whole year. Everybody took a day, you know, Monday to Sunday, and everybody would pray. And so we thank them very much because they were able to participate in that way. But here's a good thing. Here's the beautiful news. In 2020, when the pandemic hit, a lot of the churches in Kenya everything was shut down. And so many of the pastors were really going through a tough time. And somehow this team here, I believe, you know, was able, some from the team were able to, you know, feel the grace to just be able to be a blessing to some of those pastors. We had what, Bishop Ronnie was calling Christmas in April. And so there was a little something, that just a little support that was coming over to those coordinators, and they were just absolutely thankful because many of them didn't have anything to, I mean, the churches were closing and nobody was meeting, and there's just nothing going on. And so that income that kept coming month by month by month, we had Christmas in April, then we had Christmas in May, then we had Christmas in June. Then we had Christmas in July, glory to God. Many Christmases in 2020, hallelujah. Then we had Christmas in August. And then we had Christmas in September. We had so many Christmases, hallelujah. Eventually, we had our last Christmas in November before the real Christmas in December, hallelujah. So, but that was made possible from this time. So I want to just say a very big thank you. Please appreciate our gratitude and our thanksgiving from all our coordinators, and we're very, very thankful to the Lord for that. So thank you very much. And we are very grateful to the Lord. We look forward to what the Lord is going to do in 2022 in Jesus' name. Come on.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Now you get to see what it's like at a regional meeting in Kenya when the three of us are doing the meeting. So I'm we're like an Oriole because I'm sandwiched between these two guys. And so we go from shredded wheat to banana pudding to bluebell ice cream. And I'm the shredded wheat compared to these guys. However, I'm real deep. But anyway. But we have a blast when we go, because I used to do all of these all by myself. And I would go all day long. We would do about 6-7 hours of teaching. Now I have to fight for an hour and a half because these guys have really taken it and run with it. And I sit back now and let the sons run while I go have a Coke and a snack or whatever until it's my time again. And these guys, they are awesome. And when they go by themselves, I don't even know what happens. I don't even ask what happens. But they're doing a great, doing an awesome job, and I love them and appreciate them. And when I've been getting ready for this meeting, I've been getting ready for this meeting for 5 years, but when I was getting ready to put this all together, I was wanting to summarize just some of the things that stand out to me of how we've got to where we were and to where we are today. And looking at the bigger picture, I just wanted to use one words or a couple of words here and there that basically summarize what the Lord has done. And the first word that comes to me is favor, that we have had a lot of favor, from God. He has gone before us. He's kicked in doors that didn't look like anybody would be able to open. He's moved in situations that were jammed. He gave us favor with key people at the right time to help us open doors. That's a big factor. As Pastor Chola was saying, when the guys talked to them, they said, nobody knows who you are, and you don't have any people, and there's nobody that knows you. And I thought, we do know one person, and he is a pretty good people. You know, he's a pretty good person here to know that we know him and he knows us. And we got favor in the courts. I wish we had about 3 hours just to tell you more miracles. We've seen so many miracles that's happened. There's no way we could tell you all that's happened. But we spent a lot of time in court and saw God do so many things. He brought a favor with this contractor that I showed you. This is just another blessing that has happened because of how he's doing it, who he is, just the way he approaches it. It's been for Kenya, we feel like we have the best person for this job that we could have in Kenya. And that is an amazing statement. The other word that comes and summarizes everything is what I call support. We've had so much support from you guys, from people who are part of Mission Barnabas, and those who are, all of you in this room, those who are watching online. We've had so much. You've supported us with so much encouragement and prayer, financial support. You stood with us in faith and sacrifice. And I really hope you can sense my feeling and spirit of gratitude tonight for you and all that you have done to help us and to get here. Because we could not be where we were at if it was not for those who are in this room and those who are part at other parts of the country that have stood with us. There's no way we could have done this. And what if you saw some of the video playing when you came in, that what the final thing is going to look like and all the buildings, I hope you feel ownership tonight. I hope when you see all this that this is something we've all done. And it's been such a blessing. And I just want you to know we're here and have done this not by ourselves, but with the help of God, and what you have done to help us has been tremendous. And if you, when you see all of this here, if you, let's say in 2011, you gave $10,000 to Mission Barnabas, and that was the value then. Now, when we finish, what you gave then is four times in value. So your $10,000 that you gave is now valued at $40,000 because of all of the blessings. Mom bought the land when she bought it at $11,000 an acre, and we sold it to the government for $350,000. That's what they paid us, $350,000 an acre. That's good inflation there. That's a kind I like. That's kingdom inflation. But anyway, that you're giving, is the value of it is now gone up. And after what you're going to give tonight, there ain't no telling how many times this is going to quadruple. I want to thank the CMM staff, too. That's another word that comes to mind. These guys here and our staff on CMM, they're incredible. All the hours after hours, meetings, all kinds of lawyers' offices and courts and banks and building supply places and so forth. These guys have got it done, along with the Mission Barnabas Board and the CMM Board. That all of that has helped us get to where we're at today. The other word that comes to mind is relationships. And I say that because when God brings somebody in your path that's the right person at the right time, and it's a divine connection, then that relationship, if God's arranged it, fruit is going to come from that, and blessing is going to come from that. And God, over the, I can't name all of them, I have to sit down to try to remember all of the ones, but there's several that come to mind that God brought into our path at the right time. And one of those, when we were stuck, when the Ethics and Anti-Corruption Committee wanted to take a look at us about our situation because several reasons, when they take eminent domain in your property in Kenya, most of the time, if they're going to do a road or something, they may pass through somebody's land and take a quarter acre or half an acre or an acre, and they pay you for that amount. In the history of Kenya, we are the largest payout of taking over someone's land because the railroad, the way it went right through our property in such a way there was nothing left on either side. They had to take all of our property. And so when they paid us out that, it raised red flags everywhere. There's bound to be something wrong here. We got to go check on them. There's corruption involved, and there's a lot of money. And when there's a lot of money involved, there's a lot of vultures that are circling. And so they put the pressure on. That's why we went in, and we got log jammed. We got stuck. They wanted to bring their case, and they had their side, and we had our side. And they all together, between the two of us, we had 33 witnesses that were to be called. The first witness, it took 4 months just for that one witness. If something hadn't happened, we'd still be there. Probably on number 12 right now, because the courts are so slow. The judge, when you're there in front of the judge and the lawyer talks, he handwrites everything the lawyer said. So you have to wait till they get all that written out and can move on. And then you go and they get there that day and the judge has a cold. So he sends everybody home. And then the next day they decide to call a holiday or whatever. And so you go, it takes forever. And we were out of money. We were almost at the end. We didn't know what we would do next. I could not afford to lose all of this, because if I lost it on my watch and when I die and go to heaven, I would have no problem with Jesus. He would understand. I'd just have to avoid my mother when I got to heaven if I lost all of this. So this whole thing was jammed up, and we didn't know. We didn't know what would happen. And but then there was a relationship that developed where the U.S. ambassador got a hold of our situation. His wife saw in one of our newsletters what was happening to us. When we put that out, and they have a ministry in Kenya to youth. They had been bringing their youth to Count Me In, and their youth loved it. They came every year. When she saw that wasn't what was about to happen to us, she got burdened, and she told her husband something, let's help these people. So tonight, we have the ambassador and his wife here with us. Hallelujah. You guys, come on up, Kyle. Yeah, come on up here. Yes. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. When they got involved, our breakthrough started. And they called, they had become to the U.S. Embassy and meet some FBI guy in Justice Department. He took over our case. He read all of our documents. He listened to all the audio tapes. They did a deep dive for several weeks. I don't know. Was my background okay? Did I do it okay? So, they did all of this stuff. And when they finished, then they decided to go and have a meeting with the EACC, who was investigating us in the case. Went in for 2.5 hours, had a meeting. When we didn't really know what happened in that meeting. We didn't really know about it until the next time at court, when one of the guys from EACC saw Chola. He said, "We need to talk." And he said, "Listen." He said, "The ambassador came and he brought a team and they sat down for 2.5 hours with us." And he said, "What they showed us about CMM and proved to us all of this, the work we'd done looked like kindergarten kind of work." And this, I don't know if that's all the way you heard it, but that's the way they told Chola. And said, he told us, "This is people, take care of us, take care of them." And after that, they settled, we got our money. And because of all of that, that happened that way with those, that breakthrough, I want to tell you, we know somebody. Yeah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Well, thank you for inviting us tonight. It's quite an honor to be with you. I told Ron, I looked at the WhatsApp message when you gave me the news. And I said, I just did my job, because that was my job, to defend Americans. But what a great thing. I think back of 1987, when I had been 2.5 years out of college at Oral Roberts University, and Victoria and I decided to move to Kenya and live out in the middle of nowhere, building a medical clinic. And I remember people saying, "Why did you go?" And honestly, I didn't have an answer. I don't think Victoria had an, she may have had an answer, but it probably, she wasn't going to answer that. She has a few feelings about what happened, because it was a tough time for both of us. And we just didn't understand why we went. But God had a plan. And how I could never have imagined coming back in 2019 to be the ambassador. And so God had a plan. And so I guess I can answer that question now. I couldn't then, but I can answer it now. That God has given us favor, each and every one of us. God has given Victoria and myself favor to be in the position and have this great opportunity, not just to serve our country, which we love so much, but to serve Americans, especially those who are called with a purpose to reach the people of Kenya, which we all love. Yes. So thank you for what you're doing. Your investment is a good one. And you are part of something that is miraculous. Why not be part of something miraculous? Yeah. And so keep up the good work. You're part of something miraculous, and God will continue to give us favor. Thank you.
Amen. Thank you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We believe that God put him there for such a time as this for us. Hallelujah. Because with all the way that everything happened, and in case you're wondering if CMM is legitimate, the Department of Justice has turned us upside down, and we made it. Hallelujah. So it's a great investment. Hallelujah. The other thing that I wanted to, another relationship, is the contractor that I told you about. His name is Andrew. And he has, just a whole miracle how we met him and how he came into our situation. But he has, he's basically become almost like a team member. He is so thrilled to be able to do this. He's excited. He's out there almost every day. He recommends changes for us, and you know how contractors are. If you change one thing at $1,000, he doesn't do any of that. He just says, you need to do this, do that, because that when you see our houses, that prettiest one you saw is ours. They have to do the chairman's the best one, you know. So that's that. But however, those houses for the staff, they're not our houses, okay? It's the ones we would live in. CMM owns these houses. When we're finished, somebody else will come to that house. We didn't need an upstairs, but we have the room left for it. But the next person, if they have a large family, they can finish it out. We don't need that much, but that belongs to CMM. But we are going to be great stewards of it, hallelujah. And we're thrilled about that. He comes in because Chola, he loves Chola as the executive director. When he saw the final plans, he told Chola, you don't have enough room. And so they took 400 square feet that we wasn't going to use, gave it to Pastor Chola, and enlarged his house. And then he said, you need a patio here. Chola said, I can't go over the budget. He said, don't worry about that. He did all of that. Our house, he wouldn't even give us a limit on what we're supposed to go do. Just go pick out what we want, because being the chairman, I'm a lot higher than executive director. And so you got to have a little rank there. I'm enjoying this. So, but he's been such a blessing, and we praise the Lord for bringing him into our life. Then you're going to see a picture here of another gentleman. This man is named Hippolytus Shikoli. And years ago, when he was single, he heard my dad preach. Then he got married, and then my dad passed away. He went to a meeting where Mom was teaching. And him and his wife fell in love with Mom. In fact, their first daughter is named Jewel. They named their first daughter after her. He's been coming to our conferences. He's been working with pastors. But he really went into education. And he spent all of these years in getting degrees and study and education. And so come to find out, the Bible college that we're starting, what the government did a few years ago was call together a lot of key leaders and pastors and ask them to put together a curriculum for pastors on theology and Christian ministry and counseling that would be valid, that the hours you took, let them design it, and the government would certify a diploma. You can even get a doctorate in it, but they would certify, and they made a path for pastors who did not graduate with more higher than C minus. There's a way for three semesters they can take courses and get to where they can now enter into to go get a certificate. And they designed all of this. It's really, there's page after page after page of documents, all of the detailed work. This guy has been in it since ground floor. He's now right at the top. He knows everything about it. And I didn't even know he was in doing this. We called him the other day when I was there to CMM to talk with us. He said he wants us to go right now and go ahead and become our own institute. He'll get us qualified. But we told him, no, we need 2 years. We got so much on our plate. Let us do. We're going to still go with the college we're going under now for certification. But the paperwork's already started. He's going to walk us through. He's a walking encyclopedia. He said CMM will eventually be its own institute. You'll have your own accreditation, and it's valid accreditation that has the government seal on it, that when you get it, it's the real thing. Because some places in Kenya, you can go for 4 months there and you get a doctorate. A doctorate of theology in 4 months. It's briefcase colleges, and some of them you can get a thing in about 3 weeks. You can get a degree, but they don't hold water, and we're not after that. And so this guy's going to walk us through. What a divine relationship! Hallelujah, hallelujah. Then we got a great relationship with the Christian book distributors. We ordered some concordances at the cheapest one we could find. I asked them, could they give us even a more of a discount? they contacted me. They were looking for ministries overseas that work with pastors in colleges that they could partner with. And we said, we qualify, so we get anything they have at their cost. The concordances that normally cost us $12, we get them for $6.70, as many as we want. They publish their own concordances. And then they've sent us pallet after pallet of brand new books, and they call me. I talked to him the other day, and he said, look, there's these theologians and pastors came together and put together a list of the top 14 books that a pastor needs to have in his library and an ESV study Bible. And he said, there's 15 of them together. I have set you aside for CMM 254 sets of these. They're just waiting for us to be shipped to us. Hallelujah. Oh, what a great relationship. That's something only God can do. Hallelujah. And so that's been another word, a great word is relationships. Another word has been strategic. Because there's so many things. The location where we're at, it's up high. There's no mosquitoes. Hallelujah. There's no dust. There's no snakes. And it's basically heavenly temperature all year long. The Kenyans wouldn't agree, because if it gets below 70 degrees, it's like being in Alaska. But it's a great, great weather. And it's a great location. They've been building all these new highways. Now you can get to the airport, to our new property, sooner than you could to the old property. And it's all basically on four-lane highways there to get there. And where we're at in the country, we're only a little bit from the one of the train stations of SGR that ran us out. Now there's a train station that the pastors can come all the way by train to that place. We can go pick them up, or they can take a little short ride to the Bible college. So we're going to use SGR to improve where we're headed in the ministry. Hallelujah. So all of that has been strategic. Timing is another word. During COVID, all these offices closed. All this happened. We couldn't have meetings and so forth. But that gave us plenty of time to chase permits and to do all the surveys and all of that. While we had a downtime, we were doing all of the groundwork to get everything ready. And the timing of that worked good. And so we praise the Lord for that. And now, the final word is basically, we're now, believe the Lord has prepared us and is preparing us for the next season of going forward. We've seen all that God's done so far. We believe there's something very strategic about where we're about to head and going forward, because we believe after all the building is finished, we're on the verge of an explosion of ministry and to see things multiply, because there's so much momentum. The pastors can't wait. They're constantly waiting. When are you opening? They want to know. Tomorrow, our coordinators are going to receive these two videos on their app, WhatsApp, on their phone, on our group that we have. I guarantee you, soon as they get it, our phones on that app will start to blow up, because what's going on? They will be crying. They'll be shouting. They'll be saying, can we come early? They'll be doing all of this because they're so excited. And we're so well located where we're at in Kenya. I believe we're going to, because we already affect Uganda and Tanzania and Rwanda. I believe we're going to also move to other. We've already been getting invites, but we probably won't go to Ethiopia for a while. But we've been getting invites to Zimbabwe and Zaire and all these places. And we'll have the foundation, the groundwork. We'll have all the things we need to minister to all kind of groups. Send people out. People can headquarter there. All kinds of the areas to keep guests, so forth. All of that is going to happen. Well, that brings us to tonight, where we're at here. And let me explain to you, we still need your help on some things, because when we took a look at all of this, and when we were paid, when all of the situation came about, and we were paid the they were talking about earlier, when we looked at that, the money that we were getting would replace everything that was taken. We needed more dormitory spaces. All of you know, every conference we needed to build another building, so forth. So to build everything just to replace it. The money that we got when we got to 8.5, you take out what still owed us, which is 1.4, and we believe 2022 is our year of victory. We believe that we're going to have a victory here. If it's not, it'll be 23. And if it's not, it'll be 24. We will have the victory in this at some point. The other people that's suing us, they had one guy. He's already testified. He made so many lies. And the next person on the stand, December the 15th, Pastor Chola. Now, when Pastor Chola gets up there, would you want to be on the other side of what he's going to say after he finishes singing? Hallelujah. So what we did is we said, okay, we need to replace this, but not only replace it, where are we going in the future? And what do we need to do to expand? Because the Lord gave us this property, and it's awesome. For security reasons, we've got to put a wall all the way around it. We've got to add more security. Because of having large groups, we have to have a small clinic on the property. We need a number of different things like that. We were looking at it to how can we do for the next things we need going forward because of the amount of ministry. We moved from 55,000 square feet to 136,000 square feet. That's a big increase. The largest conference that we've had of pastors was 1,250 at one time at the OCMM. And when you only have 350 beds, that's a squeeze to do that. And they were in tents and on cots and all of that. Count me in when if you have the room, they can have 1,000 to 2,000 youth come for count me in. And they were all scattered all over the property everywhere. Now we're saying come. Just come because we will be able to take it. When we decided to do the big dormitory, at first it was 5 stories. That means we had to put an elevator in. The top story was so that we could have a place where they could go wash their clothes. We said, this is going to cost too much to do that. We removed that floor. Then we removed the floor that was just all dormitory rooms. And the three floors we have now are all, they contain 110 self-contained rooms. They have a toilet and shower and all of that. And so they're bedrooms. We can put not two married couples, but we can put two college students or one married couple in a room now. So we can have a marriage conference for 110 married couples, which is awesome. But we can keep 660 pastors in that, where they're all separate rooms. But then we decided, okay, we put in the plans for the future what we called overflow dormitories. We just did a basic one-story dormitory that it goes, it has 100, it'll sleep 180 pastors, and it's got showers and toilets and all that on each end for there, and you've got cubicles that you have 8 beds in a cubicle. And so we designed this to put 2 of these overflow hostels there. And so if you are in a dormitory, if you put a dormitory, it's good if you have a bed. You know, you put beds in it. And so as we looked at this and we thought, okay, to do everything we want to do, because we looked at it and decided if we didn't feel like we could do everything we needed, we may have to wait on building one building. We'll wait on that. Which building would that be? Would that be the auditorium? Would that be the guest house? Would that be the admin building? And so as we looked at it and figured out the whole thing, to do it all, to build, replace CMM plus the new things that we would need to add and build and increase the space, then let me make sure I got the numbers right. Yes, the total to do all of that would be $7,422,000. That would do all the buildings that we've seen on the loop, plus build the 2 overflow hostels and then put the beds in it. And so if we needed that, that would get everything we need. And until we're paid, when we're paid, we're going to upgrade. We're going to upgrade our sound. We're going to upgrade kitchen. We want to buy a tractor. We're looking at a radio station. A lot of the things that seem to be coming together when we get our $1.4 million. But until then, we want to be able to make sure we got plenty of room and to do this. And so if you look, and we need 7,422,000, the miracle, the big miracle has already happened. We got 7.1. So if you subtract, that leaves only $322,000. Say only. Okay, just want to make sure we're together here. Okay, so what we did is decide, Lord, how can we approach this? And then we could all take a part in it. So what we're just going to share with you is just go big or go home. You know, what we're going to share with you is let's see what God will do. And part of what we're going to do on the overflow hostel, to build this totally, it's 5,600 square feet. It'll sleep, one of them will sleep 180 pastors and youth, and it's 5,600 square feet, and so it comes out to $17 a square foot. And so if somebody wants to build something and name it after your mother or you or your wife or whatever, if for the big givers, this is your time to get awake and to have fun. We believe that between now and the next few months, we're believing that God, the two people are going to come forth who are going to build this for us. Or somebody here tonight may put together and go shoulder tap and talk to some friends, and four or five of you, or you get the, you'll get the money for us to build that overflow hostel. Then so there's two of them. We'd like to build two. The contractor, he wants to help us do this, because that's an awesome price to build that, because all of his equipment's still there, all of his workers, he'll be there till July. We don't have to bring other stuff back in. It'd be a whole lot more expensive. Prices are going up every day. And so he's agreed that he will build it for us, and we have until August of 2023 to pay for it. So some of you big givers, if you can't get $95,000 between now and 23, then come back next banquet and we'll preach on faith or whatever. Hallelujah. But I believe that I believe it's out there. I believe God will help us and show us the way. We have other ideas. And so that's part of the way that takes care of a big bulk of it. The rest of it, well, we need more beds. We have pretty much everything we need right now to have a conference. We have all the plates and saucers and dishes. We have chairs. We have tables. All the things we had at CMM are in storage. We have 350 beds and mattresses, sheets, and blankets. We need 660 in the main dormitory, and then we'll need another 360 when the Lord gives us the money for the overflow hostels. Well, then we'll need beds for those. If it's a little slow on the beds, we've got 400 cots as well. And if it's a youth event, we can put the cots in it. They don't care. So we'll figure it out. But if you would like to help us with this, you're not the one that can do the $95,000, but there's other ways, then we want to challenge you tonight to do one or two things. Maybe you could furnish a room. To furnish a room, that's four beds, that's mattresses, sheets, blankets, and pillow. It's $300 for the whole unit for a bed. For if you do a whole room, which is $1,200, then do I have a deal for you? Hallelujah. Because we will make up a plaque, and it will have your name on there on the door. It'll say, this room furnished by, and so then it'll have those that we believe the Lord's speaking to right now, that we will do this here, where your name will be on the plaque. And if you haven't seen your name, just put your name in there where that is at. So what we do, that would be $1,200 just for one room. We believe some, they want to have more than one plaque in a dormitory. They would like to have plaques, several of them. So you may want to do five rooms. Yes, you may want to do more. And then if not, if you can do one bed, that's $300. We don't need that money till May the 15th. And you got a great income tax return coming back in April. well, it used to come back then. But anyway, you would believe in the Lord, it'll eventually come, but you have until then to do it. Now, we're in this, in your the offering envelopes that are in the on your table there, inside of them, there is a little blue card. And on this blue card, you could fill this out on what you would believe the Lord, and we will pray in a moment that he will have you do as you talking and praying, and you talk to your husband and your wife, and y'all compare notes, and whichever one has the highest amount, that's God. And so y'all agree on that, and we'll go for that and in just a moment. But I want to tell you that tonight with this envelope, the money that you will give tonight, many of you give at the banquet, you bless us with a gift and so forth. Let me tell you that that is such a blessing, because the way that Mission Barnabas, the way we survive and continue and do what we're doing is just for these kind of gifts and things we challenge you for throughout the year. The beds and the buildings, that's projects. And I, at times it's like I've talked to some people that they say, well, I don't guess Mission Barnabas needs money anymore. You guys got millions. The millions is over there. You saw how we're doing it, and the ambassador's watching us. So you see how the money is going there to being spent. That's for to replace and do all of that there. For here, for Mission Barnabas, we still send in containers, buying Bibles, cost of shipping for things to bring books in that are given to us free. Debbie and I, to have steak rather than French fries, for us to eat, for us to travel, for us to do all the things we do, our office and everything, that comes by, a lot of that will be giving tonight, and those who will give between now and the end of the year, who, and then we have churches, different ones who pledge monthly, and from all of that, that's how Mission Barnabas carries on the ministry that we're carrying on. So I wanted to make sure you got a good distinction there. Between that, because we worked so hard for the last 18 years to build up CMM, and now CMM is exploding, and it's been going beyond the vision so much faster than we had, and it's being enlarged. The home fires here, we still have to keep that really burning. We're going over, like we said, you saw in the video, we're going for 3 months in December, move into our own home. And what a blessing, what a miracle, the things that we'll be able now to shift gears. All of us will be living in a residential area there. We have to really do that for security, too. Debbie and I couldn't, it'd be unsafe for us to live on the property by ourselves. We're going to have all these people surrounded us there. It's just a beautiful thing the way it's worked out. And to get to this point, for maybe even to be up here and to tell you this and to share, you have been the ones that have made it happen. For all the trips we've made, the travel, all the containers that we've sent. We're sending another one, by the way, in April that is be loaded. In fact, if you have a Kindle and you don't use it anymore, would you give it to us? Because the Bible College has arranged all their curriculum books that they use can be downloaded on a Kindle. And the pastors don't have to be online. We can give it to them. They can download it when they're at CMM. And then they can go and study, and hardly anybody here that I see uses Kindles anymore. You probably have one in a drawer or in your desk or somewhere. You need to get it to us so that we can give it to put it on the container, and we can give it to the Bible College student with all the books he needs to read, many of them downloaded. He can take home and study from there. That a container will go in April. And so this tonight, this tells you the whole picture. There's a lot of details I wish we had time to fill in, but I think you've seen the big picture, what we're doing. When we come back next year, now, if you want to, from this point on, we're going to be putting updates now. You won't have to wait so long to see the buildings come. If you miss one update, you'll probably miss a floor of a building that just went up. But if you're not a part of Mission Barnabas Backers, there's a Facebook page, Mission Barnabas Backers. Most of the updates will go on there, so go like that page. Some of them we'll put on the main page, but we will keep you informed, and we believe the Lord is going to do miracle after miracle as he's already been doing. Hallelujah. So thank you for your giving. I want to pray here in just a moment, and that you can ask the Lord, because you've seen all of this. And hey, by the way, there's a box here on your table. There's one for everybody. And the company that this came from is the factory where our tea that we grow at CMM has been harvested. There's a chance that there might be some tea in this bag here. In one of those boxes that came from CMM. If you drink tea that came from CMM, your body will be healed. Hallelujah. You will lose weight. Hallelujah. You got a lawsuit hanging over your head? Just drink some CMM tea. That you will be anointed. You'll be able to preach better. Anyway, don't get me started. But this will be a blessing for you when you make it. You can pray with it. This is a picture of the tea fields from CMM. So just bless you with that. Be sure and take one home with you. I think we have some extras somewhere if you want to take an extra box. But let's take a moment. Let's ask God to speak to our hearts. And then you can fill out the blue card, the white envelope. And if you're here and you want to start giving monthly, let us know that. Some who give monthly all the time, they never fill that out. They send. That's fine. If you give more than what you pledge, we know it. We send it. We thank you. The Lord bless you. And we believe the Lord's going to do great and mighty things. And I'm thrilled. Debbie and I are thrilled to represent you in Kenya and East Africa and to be a point person to carry forth the vision that's in all of our hearts, that we can't personally go there and do some of the outreach they can do in that culture, but we can touch that leader and change that leader's heart, and he goes to where we can't go and changes those people there. And we're constantly getting testimonies of miracles and blessings, churches that are growing, things that are happening, marriages. Marriages have so been changed. And if they see me coming, they run and hug their wife real quick, so I'll see them that they've listened to the marriage conference. We see all of the fruit, and it comes because you've stood with us, and you have been a blessing with us. Hallelujah. So thank you. From the bottom of our heart, the worship team is going to come and sing something in Swahili in a moment, and then we'll dismiss after you've given. But would you take a moment and let's just pray together, and let's ask the Spirit of the Lord to touch our lives and to show us exactly what He would have us to do. Father, in Jesus' name, Lord, such a joy when we see the breakthroughs, when we see the connections you've brought, when you see the miracles that you have done. We cannot say, look what we've done. We only can stand back and shake our heads and say, look what the Lord has done, to realize the hand of God. Lord, when you touch somebody and you move on them, and we're all obedient, it all comes together to make it happen. So that which we've shared tonight, that which we're fixing to do next year, and all that's in the plans, would you just lay on our hearts that you'd speak to us and give us direction on where you want us to be a blessing here, how you want it to do it, that you'll lead us and guide us in this. And we ask it in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. And also want to give a special word of thanks. There are a number of Kenyans who got up just 3:30 in the morning in Kenya, and they're watching this. They were excited. They got up early. So, Bwana Asafiwe, hallelujah. God bless you. Asante sana. I can speak some Swahili. Thank you. The Lord bless you. While they're singing, and you keep singing until that's full. You know how that is. So, they're be singing. So, let's pray together, worship together, sing with them. Bring your offerings. God bless you.
Dance and praise Him. It doesn't matter what comes my way. The greater one lives inside.
born a winner.
I'm born a winner.
More than victorious.
More than victorious.
I'm an heir of the kingdom.
I'm an heir of the kingdom.
Filled with the Holy Ghost.
Filled with the Holy Ghost.
I'm gonna dance.
I'm gonna dance and praise Him.
It doesn't matter.
It doesn't matter what comes my way.
The greater one lives inside of me. His name is Jesus.
His name is Jesus.
I'm born a winner.
I'm born a winner.
More than victorious.
More than victorious.
I'm an heir of the kingdom.
I'm an heir of the kingdom.
Filled with the Holy Ghost.
Filled with the Holy Ghost.
I rejoice. I rejoice in Him. I rejoice in Him. I rejoice in Him.
More than a conqueror.
I rejoice in Him.
More than a conqueror.
No weapon
formed against me
shall ever prosper. The greater one lives inside of me. His name is Jesus.
His name is Jesus.
I'm born a winner.
I'm born a winner.
More than victorious.
More than victorious.
I rejoice in Him. More than a conqueror.
More than a conqueror.
I rejoice in Him.
More than a conqueror.
No weapon
formed against me
shall ever prosper.
The greater one lives inside of me.
His name is Jesus.
His name is Jesus.
I'm born a winner.
I'm born a winner.
More than victorious.
More than victorious.
I'm an heir of the kingdom.
I'm an heir of the kingdom.
Filled with the Holy Ghost.
Filled with the
so
Holy
I rejoice.
Ghost.
I rejoice in Him. I rejoice in Him.
I rejoice in Him.
More than a conqueror. A song that says, no weapon that is fashioned against us shall ever prosper in Swahili. Mm. You ready?
Yep. That's right.
Hakuna silaha yoyote iliyotuwa kinyume chetu itakayofaulu. Ima hakuna silaha yoyote iliyotupwa kinyume chetu itakayofaulu. Hakuna silaha yoyote iliyotupwa kinyume chetu itakayofaulu. Silaha yoyote iliyotumwa kwa njia moja au nyingine na nchi kavu hayatafaulu. Hakuna silaha yoyote iliyotumwa kinyume chetu itakayofaulu. Hakuna silaha yoyote iliyotumwa kinyume chetu maneno maovu yaliyonenwa na walio hai na walio kufa chini ya maji na nchi kavu hayatafaulu. Hakuna silaha
yoyote iliyotumwa kinyume chetu itakayofaulu hakuna silaha yoyote iliyotumwa kinyume chetu itakayofaulu
one more time
hakuna silaha yoyote iliyotumwa kinyume chetu itakayofaulu.
Well, praise the Lord. Thank you so much. I just want us to take a moment before everybody leaves. I know everybody's trying to get out of here, but we just want to take a moment and just thank Jesus. And the best way we know as Africans is to give a shout of praise. You have not heard praise until you hear Africans praise Jesus. And so we just want to take a moment and just give a shout and just thank God for everything we do. Can we do that together? So in the count of three, I just want to hear all these Texans shout as much as you can. So one, two, three. Yay! Thank you, Jesus, for everything you've done. I want to thank everybody for coming. May God richly bless you. For those of you who are at home, Mungu abariki, ninafuraha sana, muliweza kutujoin, na Mungu abariki mwikienda kulala. So God bless you, and we will see you next year. Also, real quick, December 15th, mark that in your calendars. Would you be praying for us? Because that's when the court case is going to be taking place. So December 15th, please be praying with us. Thank you so much.